Hello everybody, Teagan here with High Point Scientific. Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's episode of What is in the Night Sky this month, September edition. And this marks the 12th episode, which means we've been doing this for an entire year. We thank you so much for your support, your comments, your constructive criticisms. Doing these videos is so much fun, and the entire High Point Scientific team thanks you for staying with us. So for tonight's episode, we will be traveling through the galaxy, looking at several beautiful deep sky objects for both visual astronomers and astrophotographers. So as always, buckle in, and let's see what's really out there. So the first object on tonight's list lies 1,100 light years away in the constellation of Vulpeca. Our sun actually has the same fate as this object we're about to view, and that would be a planetary nebula, also known as Messier 27, the apple core nebula, or the Dumbbell Nebula. Messier 27, the Dumbbell Nebula, can be found just a little more than 3 degrees north of Gamma Sagittae, and it appears within the same binocular field of view of this star. With binoculars and under relatively dark skies, Messier 27 appears as a faint circular misty patch, while a small telescope should clearly show it at 35 times magnification. It's large and it's bright. It has two distinct lobes that give it a rectangular shape. Using inverted vision, we'll bring out some of this detail with filaments stretching to the north and south. Through a larger telescope, this view can be quite spectacular, with the nebula taking on a shape of a bow tie or an apple core. Using a filter, such as an O3 filter, increases the contrast and really helps to bring out some texture and detail within this planetary nebula. If you're an astrophotographer, you can take advantage of your hydrogen alpha oxygen 3 filters or your dual band filters, or you can just shoot this with no filter at all with a DSLR or a one-shot color camera. You will get some extremely beautiful results either way. The next object on our list is also a deep sky object and is a planetary nebula known as the Helix Nebula or the Eye of God. Now, you'll need to be under dark skies if you want to find the Helix Nebula with binoculars, while telescopically, you'll get the best view with lower magnification. A light pollution filter and averted vision definitely help. And this is because its light is dispersed over an area roughly half the size of the full moon, making it appear fainter than its listed magnitude suggests. When viewed with a medium-sized or large scope, you see a large smoky ring with a very faint, ill-defined outer edge. While this nebula can be viewed visually, it is a spectacular target for astrophotographers. Now, this next target is one of the most commonly photographed nebula in the night sky, NGC 7000, otherwise known as the North American Nebula. This is another target for dark skies, visually speaking. The North American Nebula is visible to the naked eye and can be found beside the star Deneb, the brightest star in the constellation of Cygnus. It is best observed with binoculars. Photographically speaking, and specifically with narrowband filters, this nebula emits some spectacular light in hydrogen alpha, oxygen 3, and sulfur 2 emissions. Using these three filters will provide you with a spectacularly detailed photo. The Cygnus Wall and the Pelican Nebula are also located within NGC 7000. It is such a fine target for an astrophotographer. Now we have a couple more deep sky objects we're going to view, but first, let's bring it in a little bit and let's see what the moon and the planets are up to. Venus is lost within the sun's glare this September, but you may be able to glimpse Mercury very low in the west during the first few days of the month. Saturn can be found in Capricornus and is still an outstanding sight for telescopic observers. The nearly full moon will join close by on the 8th and the 9th. Distant Neptune reaches opposition on the 16th, with Jupiter following suit on the 26th. But while Jupiter outshines every star in Pisces, its host constellation, Neptune may be a challenge. The just-past full moon squeezes between Jupiter and Neptune on the 11th. Uranus comes into opposition in November and therefore rises mid-evening this month. Mars is slowly brightening and rises around midnight among the stars of Taurus. Look for a last quarter moon beside it on the morning of the 17th. Lastly, the moon turns full on the 10th and then new on the 25th. Now it is time to head back out into deep space, and we're going to view an object that is very easily seen and very easily found, Messier 15. Now here is a gorgeous globular cluster. It comfortably fits within the same binocular field of view as Enif, the star that makes the nose of Pegasus, the flying horse. It's even bright enough to be picked out in suburban skies with standard 8x32 binoculars. Through a small telescope at about 35 times magnification, the cluster appears as a small, hazy, comet-like patch with a bright core. Increasing the magnification to around 80 times will improve the view a little, with the core appearing to extend two-thirds the way towards the cluster's edge. As globular clusters go, this one is quite condensed, with some resolution being possible with larger scopes at around 200 times magnification. Now, while Messier 15 is a gorgeous globular cluster, Messier 2 is another globular cluster that is arguably just as gorgeous. Messier 2 is a globular cluster for late summer. It's visible with binoculars and can be found under suburban skies. The downside is that this cluster lies in the comparatively faint constellation Aquarius. Binoculars can help to locate it. Telescopically, it appears uniformly gray, but with a bright large core. Chances are you'll need a larger scope and a magnification of about 100 times to resolve any of the individual stars. A smaller scope may show some texture around its edges. So if you are a visual astronomer or an astrophotographer, or even if astronomy just interests you down to the core as a human being, we urge you to go outside and take a look at these objects if you can. If you live in dark skies, and especially if you have a pair of binoculars, the Dumbbell Nebula and the two globular clusters are fantastic objects to start with. That being said, we thank you so much for tuning into this month's episode of What is in the Night Sky, September edition. It has been a fantastic year, and we can't wait to keep producing these kind of videos for everybody. Thank you so much, and clear skies.